Hi guys, my name is Jason.
And I'm Lorraine.
We went to pick up our Azure Standard, which is a bulk buy group that we belong to. And what did we buy?
We got some cheese, some spices, and some beans, and rice, and butter, and some olive oil. And then from another farmer friend, we purchased some maple syrup and honey.
Now we're gonna talk to you guys about our top five, not in order necessarily, but it's gonna be our top five bulk buys that we buy for us, for our family. And then we're gonna talk about how we store all this bulk buying food for us.
If we just need like one bean, we might just purchase like a 25 pound sack of it. But since this month we needed a bunch of little extra little things, we just got the smaller bags. These are 5 pound bags, and I ended up getting 2 of the pinto beans and then 5 pounds of rice, 5 pounds of split peas, because we ended up spending the bulk of our money on these. This is what we purchased this month, but I want to show you some of the stuff that we've purchased in the previous months and how we store it.
Oh, that's a lot of beans.
Something that we've purchased before, a couple months ago, we use this a lot here on our homestead, is apple cider vinegar. It's good for the animals, it's good for us, and it comes with this really neat pour spout nozzle, I'm not sure, and you can just twist this off, and then there's like a little pour spout that comes out of it, and you can pour it into smaller jars, which I have. I've got some of these 1 gallon mason jars, which we've poured it out into there, and then put it into our pantry.
Yeah, we use some of the apple cider vinegar for the brothers. Spoiled pigs. We got these buckets. These are food grade buckets, and you can get these at a big box store, such as Lowe's or Home Depot, or they sell them on the Azure website. For the lid, they usually sell these separate, and they're a little bit more expensive lids because they screw off. And here you just snap it on, unscrew it, and it's just easier to put food in here and take food out if it's just a screwed on lid.
If you are in a pinch and you need a food grade storage bin, you can go to your local grocery store, and in the bakery section, they have these food grade bins that used to have icing or cake icing in them, and they are airtight. They are a little tricky to open, but they will give them to you for free or maybe at a small fee. But they are not 5 gallon, they are like 35 pound buckets. I've got black beans in this one, and in a couple other ones, I have some other beans. Another way that we store some of our bulk buys, these are some medicinal herbs in bulk. Sometimes they come in giant 1 pound bags. And what I like to do is put a small jar for us to use during the month. And then you can store them in mason jars, but we're pretty short on mason jars because we use them for canning. And so we have these food saver bags that we vacuum the air out. We store them this way in a dark storage container. You can put them in a bin like that or just put them in a dark storage container. The butter from Azure Standard is actually really, really good quality, and it's such a great price. You can buy a whole case of it, and how we store the butter is we just put it right into the freezer. I like these 1 gallon mason jars that I purchased from Azure Standard in my last month's shipment. I ordered these, and I got a few of them, and they are great for storing. We just keep them in a dark, cool place. And this is just a regular ball, 1/2 gallon size. We keep our sea salt in here. Now let's talk about our top five food bulk buys that we like to purchase. The first one, it would have to be grains. We like to buy our grains in bulk. This is our rice that we buy. I have purchased before a 25 pound sack. I would have to say about 4 to 5 months that it would last our family. The second thing would have to be legumes, and that is any type of beans. We like pinto beans, black beans, chickpeas, even these split peas, and even lentils. And we purchase those as we need them. Right now, I currently have some in my pantry, but I didn't want to run out, so I bought another 5 pound bag. Number 3 would have to be oils. Now, these things that we buy in bulk are things that we cannot grow ourselves here on our homestead. We can use some of the pig fat as cooking oil, but there's nothing like a good solid olive oil, or even avocado oil is something that I've purchased in the past from them, even coconut oil. Our number four bulk buy is spices. And this is something I didn't learn until later in my life. I'm so old. This is something that I didn't learn until much recently. I used to buy the spice containers brand new every single time, and I used to be like, wow, goodness, they're so expensive. But then somebody told me about buying spices in bulk, and they are so much more affordable, and you get to keep your glass container that you first purchased, and then just refill them as you need them, and you can store these in mason jars, and then just pour out what you need. Some of the spices that we bought this month was curry powder. This and this is a fantastic meal. Where's the rice? So this and this is a fantastic meal right here. We bought cinnamon powder. We go through a lot of cinnamon. I'm actually wondering if I should have bought 2 pounds. Cumin seed powder. This is ground cumin. Turmeric. We actually use a lot of turmeric, and we were out. Whole cumin. This is very good. We put this is a whole meal in itself too. So pinto beans and cumin powder, excellent. So I'm gonna fill up this spice jar, and then the leftovers, I'll just put it into an empty mason jar. And number five of our top five food bulk buys is cheese. We really enjoy not having to go to the grocery store very often for cheese, because there's no way that our small family of three can eat this entire 5 pound block. Is it a 5 pound block? Yes. I'll open this cheese and section it off into 1 pound blocks. I can put them into the food saver bags and shrink wrap them that way, or I can just put them into Ziploc freezer bags and then freeze them. And you can freeze cheese. The only thing is it'll be a little bit crumbly when you thaw it out and go to use it, which is perfectly fine for us.
And you could go to the Azure website. Guys, we'll put a link down in the show notes of the website, and you could purchase. Anyone can sign up and purchase bulk buys, and you got to look for a drop-off point, because there's a certain drop-off point in your area, and that's where you got to pick up all of this food at, and it comes in a big giant trailer, and you just go down there and pick it up with a bunch of people.
Yeah, which is great, because it's a nice community of people who are like-minded, and they're all purchasing in bulk and purchasing their goods together with you, and you kind of have this sense of community of like, hey, we're all purchasing together. Your purchase helps drive down the cost of my purchase, and we're all, you know, working together.
Why buy in bulk? That's a good reason for the community aspect of it. And then also, don't like going to grocery stores. Try to limit our grocery store trips. It's a lot cheaper buying things in bulk. I mean, we buy all our feed for our animals in bulk. We buy our food in bulk. And whenever you can do that, the better.
If you want to know more information, head on down below in the description box. We'll leave a link for you and a code. And that's our affiliate link code. It will help us, give us credit when you purchase something, and at no additional cost to you.
Before we moved here, when we were just out in the city, we were doing Azure Standard. So you don't have to live on a homestead or be in a more rural area. You could be in the city and still order from here.
And what I like about when you're shopping online, it gives you price per pound. So if you want to shop around, you can see the price per pound that it's giving you here. Most of the time, Azure has really good prices. So I usually end up going with Azure. But like you can see here, the price breakdown.
We really don't have no room for this stuff. So, you know, we just find a spot in the house, which is usually under our bed.
We have a very small pantry. So some stuff can go in the pantry, but the big bulky items like these gallon buckets will go underneath our bed.
Yeah, on this episode of Food Hoarders, we show you all the food.
And where we secretly store it.